Dear student, already last time we have seen universal law of gravitation, according to which every object in the universe attracts another object with the force which is directly proportional to the product of their masses and inversely proportional to the square of the distance between them. Okay, to avoid that proportionality sign, we have kept here proportionality constant G, which is known as the universal gravitational constant, which value was given by Henry Cavendish, and it was observed and accepted all over the universe, that is equal to 6.673 into 10 to the power minus 11 Newton meter square per kg square. Okay, how to find out this unit, that also we have seen. If it is the question asked, what is the capital G? Okay, so you have to say it is the universal gravitational constant whose value this. Okay. But if it is asked to define it, okay, so to find out its definition, what we can do, we can keep the masses each of 1 kg and we can keep the, this distance d is equal to 1 meter. So what will happen in this formula, if we are going to keep capital M value, small m value is equal to 1, as well as d value is equal to 1, because separation between them is 1 meter. Okay, so all these we will get 1, and hence we will get F is equal to G. This should be found if it is asked to give you the definition. F is equal to G. F is the force. What is G? G is the gravitational constant. Both are the different quantities. Okay, but they will be numerically equal. When they will be numerically equal? If both the masses is of 1 kg and they are separated from each other by a distance of 1 meter. So, how to define G here now? G is the universal gravitational constant, okay, whose value is numerically equal to the force of attraction between the two masses of 1 kg each. If they are separated from each other at a distance of 1 meter. Okay. So, that is the definition of the gravitational constant G. Okay. If it is asked the definition, you have to find it all. And you should write down it like this. Now, next question is, we are studying this law, but what is the significance, what is the importance of the law is, that question was asked many times, so you can now focus here on the importance of this law. We all are bound to the earth, okay? We all means whatever the objects on the earth that are the terrestrial objects, okay? So, binding all the terrestrial object to the earth, that is due to the universal gravitational law. Holding the atmosphere around the earth, that is due to the gravitational law, rainfall or snowfall on the earth, motion of the planet, okay, motion of the moon around the earth, or motion of any other artificial satellites around the earth, that is also due to the gravitational law only. Motion of all other the planets, we know that in our solar system, sun is the center and all the planets are revolving around it. So, motion of all these are governed by this universal law of gravitation. There is the rise and fall of the water in a sea, and that we are known as the tides. So, flow of the water in a river or tides, that is also because of the universal law of gravitation. Even we can predict the solar eclipse or lunar eclipse, that is also the by using the universal law of gravitation. Okay, so all these are importance or significance, you can say, of this law.